Alright, I think it's enough of that video. Hey, it's me and I'm back and I'm alive. So, let's see what we got here. We are up and going. I'm gonna pull up this Discord. And let's see if we can get some folks in Discord. I'm up and in Discord now. If anyone else wants to join, I am there. I believe Monica and Ben and a couple other people are going to join us, and we're going to play some multiplayer today. There, I've warned them. Come play. Yeah, I think my Discord's working. We'll see. It says it's working. I think Monica's joining us. It's so nice because now I don't have like the Skype like noise of, you know, and plays that shitty music, and then like it doesn't work. Like, I can just turn on Discord and magically it'll work. See? Monica just magically shows up. That's it, Monica. We are never using Skype for this ever again. From now on, it's all Discord. It's all better. Yeah, so there's that. How you feeling, Monica?
I have a headache.
How long did it take you to get human again?
I woke up yesterday feeling recovered and refreshed, but then I still had headache, so I guess it's not.
So you weren't really recovered and refreshed, you were just kind of, it fooled you. Alright, so I am setting up a multiplayer game for anyone that wants to join. We are playing Greythorn Peaks. I am playing as Chrysper, as I always do. I'm gonna play the Fayborn because that's the way I am today. I really need to unlock some of these other characters because I don't ever get to play some. I want to play Moco and I can't play Moco. I really need to. Can you
so
unlock?
So you started to call Chrysper Chrysper now?
Is it Chrysper? Is it Chrysper? What is it? I guess it's Chrysper because it is me, but it looks like Chrysper to me. I don't know.
Most people call it Chrysper.
I think we're just gonna call it Chrysper. We're gonna let it be Chrysper. Oh my god, look at that game fill right up. I am gonna play as yellow because that's the way I like to play. Is this Zandalus? Yeah, this is last game. Stand on Zandalus, which means I have learned from having played this game that Zandalus sucks. I'm not gonna play as Zandalus. I will not be Zandalus. That is the shit position in this game. I'm going to be up there, up where it's nice and safe and friendly. Let's play with Quick Start. Let's play with some quick battle scenes. Let's give it a nice long game so we give people a chance to get their VP on. Alright, I'm ready. Anyone else in? We got Monica. We got Merlini X, we got Alara, we got one NPC. Anyone else want in? The game is about to begin.
Ben?
Yeah, where's Ben? Where's Termite King? Where's Coolgan? He's here.
He changed his name to Raffle King.
The Raffle King. Wow, alright. I can't believe we did that thing. I'm still a little bit blown back by the thing that we did. I look back on it. So what I didn't realize is I had my arm. I don't know if you can't really see it, but my arm here like was resting on the desk to hold the mouse for so long that even now, right now, I can't feel this pinky. Like, I have done temporary nerve damage to the nerve that's right there so that this pinky and this, what is that? My ring finger, my right hand ring finger, they don't like, they feel kind of like not quite right, you know? And it sucks.
Yeah. And that happens to me for a few hours of playing, but you, 42 hours?
That was insane. That was absolutely insane. Where's Ben? Ben, get in the game. Ben's
He's away on
him. All right, well, we're going to play one without him. We'll play one with him later because I'm ready to go. I'm not waiting on him anymore. Bad luck, Ben. Bad luck, Ben! I didn't know we actually made that. The things that there's like I woke up the next day and there was like shit on my OBS that I'm still kind of like, I don't really know where that came from. Like, I'm still a little confused by some of it. I honestly, I mean, I'm not making this up. The last 15 hours or so are a really dim recollection for me. I mean, I kind of know that they happened, but I kind of like don't remember. But I have this, and I have to say, by the way, thanks for everyone that showed up for that. It was absolutely amazing. They were like, and I don't even remember who it was. Somebody was here. Do you remember, Monica? Who showed up?
Yep, they were here. Warmonger, Pyro.
And they were like, no, 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 move here, go here, do this. And I was just like, whatever, man. If I can just, like, really lost. And and somewhere around the last couple levels, the Discord started to fill up with people that weren't Boomzappers. Like, actual game players started showing up on Discord. And they were like, and I don't even remember who it was. Somebody was here. Do you remember, Monica? Who showed up?
Yep, they were here. Warmonger, Pyro.
And they were like, no, 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 move here, go here, do this. And I was just like, whatever, man. If I can just, like, just following directions to move my armies was like a major achievement for me at that point. I was so proud of myself.
MJ, do you remember that?
What?
You were shouting at MJ, do you remember that?
It's possible. I don't... What was I yelling at him about?
You were saying, the enter button says I still haven't given orders to Annette, but there's no Annette! Where's Annette? Where's Annette? And then a few realized, oh, that's not Annette, it's Deidre.
Yeah, I kind of sort of halfway remember that. I remember this. I mean, this sounds really corny. Okay, I'll just say up front, I know this sounds really corny, but there was like this amazing sense of togetherness there at the end where like we all came to, like I didn't finish this game, right? Had it just been me by myself, I would have wandered into my room and gone to sleep because like if nobody was watching me, there was no way I was going to do that shit. And B, like I could not have finished. I literally could not have gotten to the end of that game by myself. It would not have been physically possible. I did not know what was going on. There was that one level, I forget the name of the level, but it's the one where the orc tribes all gather together with a really big countries that it's like a big open level. The Bleak Coast.
The one in Meridor?
No, no, not the one with Meridor. That one was a bitch, but I remember that one. No, it was, give me a second, I'll remember the name of the level. It's the one where you started out in the middle in Red March or something like that, and you're surrounded by orcs, and the orcs all kind of team up halfway through the level, and Edwin was just like, screw it, don't do anything, just take over the lands, don't take over all the lands, just take over the cities, that's what it was, just take over the cities and portal around, and if I had not known how to do that, that game would have taken hours, because it's a big level, but the way he was playing, I think I finished it in like, 45 minutes or something reasonable. I don't know, like, I felt this real sense of like, we all came together and solved that together. And I know it's corny. I know it's really corny, but like, I don't know. Like, I felt a real sense of togetherness. It felt warm and happy to me. So, that was cool. I don't know what we achieved. I still don't know, like, what... I'm somewhere along the way, I was like, why are we doing this again? What was the point of this? And many times I did feel the I've made a huge mistake moment. I did feel that a lot while we were there. I'm gonna keep all that shit on my OBS because that there, we made some fun stuff. Oh wow! All right, so I gotta pay attention to this game a little bit. So I got, all right. So Alara Shade and Merlini X have allied. No surprises there. At least they're just allying up front now. You know, before it was like they would ally quietly, but then they would pretend to ally with somebody else, and you would think that you've got an ally, but actually you just got this dude that's gonna backstab you later. But now they're actually allying up front, so you kind of know what you're getting. So I feel better about that. Alright, yeah, come on, Kaylee. And let's see. It's spring. Spring has sprung. All right. Who's down there in Zandalus? Who is that? Is that, all right, that's Alara down in Zandalus. I've got Merlini X right underneath me. I've got Edwin right next to me. And then we've got Monica over there on Reed Isle by herself. And a silly little AI over there. So, what's the best plan here? I think we're gonna play it defensive. I think that's we're gonna turtle up a little bit. I think is how we're gonna play this. Just a little bit. We're not gonna turtle up too hard. We're gonna turtle up a little bit. A little turtle up. Some harpies. Alright, wait, I should probably move first before I get bored and start killing harpies. I'm really into killing those little harpies lately. I don't know why. You know what I've been thinking about? I want your opinion, Monica. I've been throwing around the idea that you should be able to use your allies' portals. But
I love that idea.
I like the idea, but I'm throwing around, like, I'm trying to figure out how many weird things that would create. Like, let's say right now I were to portal into my ally's city, and he was trying to portal into the same city. Which one of us, like, would I get first portal rights? I'm throwing around, but, like, go ahead.
Portal into Drogoth City the moment he leaves and cap it, so.
That's the other thing, like there would be, like, that one ability to, like, hey, I portaled into your city, I immediately got rid of our alliance, and then I took over your city. Like, that would be a little bit bold, right? But it would open up the ability to do that. So that's my worry, is it does create some pretty phenomenal backstabbing options that I'm not sure I'm totally comfortable with. But on the other side, it would also open up a lot of strategy and stuff. There's been times where it's like, oh man, I wish I could just get my army over there and help you, and I'm like, I wish I could use your portal. But I guess in that case, maybe what you could do is you could build a portal outside of your city and then use that portal and then give them, because you can give them land. I mean, I've played that angle before where I built a portal, gave them the land that was on the portal, they use that. But it becomes a quite extensive process, I guess. Alright, still pretty quiet. I don't really have anywhere to go that doesn't involve pissing off Merlini, but there's that. Parthia's big. I had not realized how big that one country was. Edwin's got a lot of country to take over. Damn it. So Merlini's got his whole country all sorted out now. I don't, because I've been too scared to take that border country, which kind of sucks. I should probably take it. I could probably take it now if I tried my mind to it. I've got some... Wait, that's not the wrong... That's the wrong guy. Alright, wait, I'm gonna go ahead and build myself a little tower here. Let's see, what are you up to? Yeah, build that. Yeah, alright. It is pretty powerful. It's very powerful in the early game. It becomes almost worthless in the late game in games that become population bound, though. But I do think there may be some balancing that needs to be done there. I think I may agree there. Hey, what am I doing? You're Kaylee. You get the extra missiles. Let's get you some of that. Let's see you go do some damage. And for the record, that owl thing is a girl. Rana's a girl. So it's not him, it's her. See, that's the thing. I noticed in all games, they always make it like, if it's a female character, it's a human female and she's pretty. And then if it's like a bear or an animal or a dragon or a something, it's always a him. And I was like, you know what? Why can't Rana... Because we were discussing it. We had discussions early on in the game where we were talking about we should have sort of gender equality in our game. We actually wanted to do that. And so you'll notice if you look at the heroes, there are quite a few female heroes. And we were doing like a count of female heroes and we're like, there's still more male heroes than female heroes. And I'm like, well, how do you know? Like, how do you know, you know, Moko the lizard? Is that, how do you know what Moko is? I mean, for all you know, those things have four sexes. You know, you don't know what the hell Moko is. But like, we decided, like, wouldn't it be cool if the owl was a chick, pun intended. But, so yeah, Rana's actually a female owl. So Rana's a she. Moko, however, is a he. And the bear is a he because the bear's me and I'm a dude. Ismith is pretty obviously a dude centaur. That's kind of a gimme. See, this is exactly what I was worried would happen. The minute I take The minute I take that one little borderland, which I'm finally doing, now I've got my army's weakened, he hasn't weakened anything, and now he's going to march up and punish me for having taken that thing. And I'm not going to be able to take it. You know what I ought to do? You know what? You take it. I'm not gonna give you that. I'm not gonna give you the joy and the satisfaction of playing that like you think you're gonna play it. You want that land, you come up and you take it yourself. I know I wanted the bonus for my country, but you know what? I can live without it. I'm okay with it. I'm fine. I don't need that in my life. You want that, you come up and take it. And then when you're trying to subjugate it, then I'll jump on you. But now I feel a little bit silly of, you know, weakening them and weakening myself. I should have just left it there. I shouldn't have taken the bait. Merlini left that there as a bait.
You only have 3 territories, Chris.
What? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 territories. What are you talking about?
Really? I can only see 3.
I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think you're stalled or something. I think you need to get your.
No, I'm spectating the match that you're on right now, directly from the client.
Then count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
You're yellow, right?
Yeah.
They even have buildings on them to make it really easy to count.
I think Nelson's smoking dope is what I think's happening.
5, Nelson!
Seriously, Darwin. I'll show you the new chat.
5!
Well, damn. That didn't really take much for Merlini to destroy that land. My plans to let him take the damage weren't really good plans at all. Yeah, alright. I gotta come up with a better plan here. I need a better plan.
He's occupying the AI.
Yeah, I know.
And he attacked me.
So now you like me as an ally, huh? Compared to Edwin.
sometimes things need to be plugged in again. Maybe that's better? Anyone? Alright, so let me know if that improved anything.
I can hear you.
Well, I mean, the thing is, you can hear me fine in Discord. Whether or not you can hear me fine on the stream is a different question. Whoa, I got screwing around with my mic and didn't worry about this. Buy some things, okay. Yeah, that was pretty obvious. Go to the country I'm not in. Oh, but a little misdirection. That was less obvious and kind of cold-blooded, but all right. Yeah, it's this. I got this snowball mic, and it when it works, it's good. But when it doesn't work, it kind of blows. And I need to figure out how to make it work more often than it doesn't work. I'm a little pissy about how that ended up. Yeah, when they work, they're good. Like, but it has a lot of issues with, like, every time I turn my machine back on, I have to, like, reinstall it a lot. I don't know why. And I don't know if that's an issue with the device or an issue with Windows or what, but, like, it forgets that it's there a lot. And if I plug it in and back in again, it's all good. Well, this is just silly. I feel like I've been very powerless this game. I feel very powerless. I'm sad. I feel like I haven't had great options. I'm not sure where I went wrong. It was that one attack into that border country. And in a way, I feel like, I mean, if you look, Krondor is a bigger country, but they don't have the shitty border country. Thelsor is the smaller country, and they've got, because what? Krondor's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lands. Thelsor's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lands. But the one who's stuck with a border country is Thelsor. Hey, Nelson. You're still there, right, Nelson?
Yes, I'm still here.
Can you take a note? I want to move that citadel. What I want to do is I want to take that citadel that's here on... what is that land called? It's called the Ridelands. Take that citadel, change it into a hamlet. And then on these lower Kron hills, this hill in Krondor, stick the citadel there, because they've got the bigger land. They should be the one that's forced to deal with the borderland. And plus, there'd be a way around that citadel to make it a more interesting situation here.
Okay, I'm on it.
I feel like in this game I was largely a stalling buffer for Edlin. Ah, so you guys take Rana, sit Rana on the castle, get a bunch of gold, use the gold to buy phoenixes, and then come up and beat the shit out of somebody with phoenixes. Which is good planning. I support that. Who you calling Rana ugly, Ben? That's a beautiful owl. Yeah, I think I'm running everything as admin. Hey, we got another drunk harpy on my screen. We gotta fix the drunk harpies. And it's only the harpies. I don't know why it's the I don't know why the harpies do it, but the harpies get drunk and fly in circles. Yeah, I got nothing here.
You can't stop.
Yeah, it's not looking good for me today. But that's alright. I'll enjoy spectating. It's always nice to have a chance to relax.
I used ceasefire on you for nothing.
Nothing? Alright, so now he's gone over to my castle, and he destroyed all the rest of my troops before he did it. Oh, that's just salt in the wounds right there. Yeah, that's me out. I'll tell you another thing I've been throwing around since I was playing the game last week. It seems weird to me that the base castle is so easy to take over. I wonder that the city should start with 3 points instead of 2. Because right now it's like 2 points and then there's a huge jump up to 5 points if you get the extra thing. And I wonder if it should be like 3 points up to 4 points or 3 points up to 5 points. But it feels like they're a little easy to take right now and it makes them feel a little bit less epic. Like, it should be a bigger thing to take over a city. Even a city that somebody hasn't put extra money into.
Yeah, we could do that. Let's test it out.
Yeah, the thing is, right now, and this is what I was really feeling when I was playing the big game, is this game is really aggressive right now. It really responds well to you building the big fucking army and just churning, you know, just going around and killing people. Alright, does my spectate now button go? Yay! Spectate now. Okay, cool. That's nice. We needed that button. It's better with it. Alright, so now we can see what's going on. Hey, but wait a minute. Oh, there we go. Well, that's weird. Like, my spectator button doesn't give me the numbers for everyone all at once. It has to, like, think about it for a minute, and then slowly it gave all of them to me. Oh, and there it is. There's the Monica-Edwin alliance that they had promised to do earlier. Maybe the moat can give one hit point as well. I kind of like the improvements all doing like one thing each and not doing like this plus that. It's a little confusing for new players to say like, oh, the moat will give you extra bonus on defense and it'll extra give you an extra hit point. It's not necessarily a bad idea, but it may be a little bit more for people to understand, and we already get a lot of comments from earlier players that they get confused. I'll tell you one other thing I've been throwing around the idea of, and I'd be curious your guys' thoughts on it. Doing a fourth branched upgrade to the cities and the fortresses. So right now, when you get to the final upgrade of the towers, that's the citadel here. Once you've got your citadel, you can't really do anything to it. And I was wondering, like, if you look at the city has like, all right, you're your final city. But now you can like add some shit to your city. I was wondering, like, what if when you got to your final citadel, there was like a branching tree where you could say like, you know what, I want to add this to my citadel. I want to add that to my citadel. Where maybe it wasn't a branching tree, but maybe it was like the city where I would see some shit down here, which is the shit that I added to my citadel. So maybe I could add a thing to my citadel that gives it more hit points, or makes it make more gold, or something like that. And do the same thing with the towns. So you could actually have like a final a final improvements to make your fortress even more badass if you wanted to. I was thinking it might be fun. I don't know. It might be too much. It's kind of simple now, and maybe we want to keep it simple. Dude, that harpy is drunk. Go home, harpy, you're drunk. Hey, Nelson, do we have a bug listed for the drunk circling harpy?
I'm not aware of such.
For whatever reason, sometimes the harpy gets drunk and he just goes in a circle around and around and around. If you look at the stream, you can see him. I've got a drunk harpy on my screen. It won't show up when you spectate because the these little things are just on the client. They're not on they're not synced. So my drunk harpy is not the same as your drunk harpy. But
so it just moves around and around?
Yeah, it just goes in a perfect circle over and over forever and ever and never stops. Although I wonder, looking at the other ones, I wonder if maybe all of them are just going in circles, and just the circles are bigger than I can see. Because all the harpies seem to just be going in circles. I am suspicious if Adrian has fooled us, because we said we wanted things to go on interesting paths. And I wonder if what he actually did with his interesting path is make everything go in a circle, but some of those circles have really big radiuses, so I just see them kind of come in and out of the level, and I think that they're flying on interesting paths, but they're not. They're actually, everything is just going in a circle. It's just going in circles that are so big I can't see the circle. I'm going to ask Adrian, because I think that's what he did, and when I see the drunk harpy, what I'm actually seeing is just a circle with a smaller radius. Now that I look at the behavior of our critters, I'm suspicious that's what he did. And he thought he was getting away with it too. Because we were like, we want interesting different paths. What?
Were they fast? They're moving around?
So, when we originally put the little critters in, the little critters went in straight lines. And they looked shit because they just went in straight lines. And I said, can they go in, you know, can they vary their path? Can they kind of go left and right or whatnot? And Adrian said, yeah, I'll do something. And I'm now beginning to realize the something that Adrian did was make them all go in circles, just really, really big circles, so that you see it like come into the level and fly sort of in a slightly circular path, but you don't really see the rest of the circle. And you don't see him for a while because he's outside of the screen, and then he comes back around and circles around again. I think that's what he's doing, because making something go in a circle is it's cheap. Computationally, circles are the cheapest thing because it's just a point and a radius. It's easy to compute that. Straight lines and circles are easy to do. Fancier paths that go in different directions and stuff are much more difficult to do. Alright, so let's see. We've got Merlini X at the top with 610, Monica at 447. And then we've got their supporting partners, Alera and Obwan, at 425 and 350. So basically what we're seeing is the people on the edges of the map are going to fight for winning, and they're going to be supported by the people in the center of the map. That's how this is going to play out. I know. Actually, I think the reason I had that idea, Kulgan, was because you suggested it. There were a couple people who suggested stuff like that, and I guess I've gone through a spirit journey on this game. No, I mean, part of what's been really interesting about early access has been us figuring out who our audience actually is, right? When we started this game, it was an iPad game. It was very much an iPad game. We started this game with the idea that this was an iPad game. It was going to be all about iPad. We were going to go get iPad users. It was totally casual. And it has become more PC and more hardcore as we've gone through the development process. And it's become that not because I wanted it to be that thing, but because that's who's actually playing it. And it's been that for a couple of reasons. I think for one, we've gotten really disappointed with the mobile crowd and trying to get mobile users interested in what we're doing and trying to get mobile users to support us because they're just really, they're really flaky. Mobile users are really flaky. They don't really get dedicated to things very much. They move from thing to thing pretty quickly. And the other thing about the mobile users is there's just a lot of content for mobile, and they're very used to different kinds of games, free-to-play mechanics, things like Clash of Clans and Clash Royale, and so they're used to that kind of experience. And when I originally envisioned this game, I envisioned it as something that kind of went out and competed with Hearthstone, actually. Not that it was a trading card game, but that it sat in that same sort of space. And I think over time I've realized that Hearthstone is actually a more hardcore game than I gave it credit for. And that this game, once it sort of came to life, it wanted to be a little deeper than it is. It wanted to be a little bigger than it is. It wanted to be on PC. And so we've made changes to bring it there. And I think as it continues to evolve, I've seen that people have a real interest. How did Edwin get all the way back there into his country? Anyway, I've seen it really evolve in this direction. And maybe 3 months ago when somebody said, hey, I think we should allow you to build things on the final version of the citadels or the final versions of the town, my answer was, yeah, that's too complex for this game. But now that I've really seen how people play it, and I've watched people get involved in it, I've watched people play tournaments of it, I'm beginning to realize, actually, maybe it's a little different. I think it's still always, we always want it to keep the same pace that it's got, we always want it to be a casual game, and it is a casual first game, but I think what we're seeing is people, once they get into it, and they get into multiplayer, they're looking for more strategies. They're looking for more different ways to prove, oh, this is the way to play the game. And we need to be very careful when somebody says, you know what, the way to play the Fae is you get Rana, and you sit him on the town, and you build phoenixes, and you go destroy somebody, and that's the only way to play Fae. When I hear that, that gets me concerned. Out of the game! Ouch, Alara. This mic is starting to piss me off. I don't know what's going on. Alright, so hopefully that fixes it. Seriously, it's just me plugging the mic in and out. I don't know what's up with that. That's annoying. I don't know if you... It shouldn't do that. I don't know, it should not do that. But anyway, back to my point. The question of do we want to get rid of crossplay? I think what we do instead, we're not going to get rid of being able to play between PC and iOS. That, in terms of marketing tool, that's just too huge to give away. As much as I might like PC more than mobile, we have to be honest with ourselves and say that there is a huge ability for us to bring users to this game by making it mobile ready. I think what we may do is just say, you know what, at its heart, it's not a mobile game anymore. At its heart, it's a PC game that plays on mobile. And we start making a few decisions that allow, that are maybe a little more hardcore. Now, in terms of user interface, I'm not about to add a bunch of keyboard commands and stuff like that. I think that gets us away from the cross-platform in a way that's unhealthy. But to say, you know what, we might make this game a little bit more detailed. We might make this game a little bit more in-depth. We might give you a few more player options. I'm beginning to come over to thinking that that's what our user base really wants. And this is the joy of early access. This is the whole point of early access, is this ability to not just fix your game, but discover your game. And I really feel through the last month or month and a half, we've kind of discovered this game. We've kind of discovered our user, and we've discovered the place that people are interested in playing this game. And it's been very interesting. And I think we need to make some changes to support that. One of the other changes that I'm gonna sit and think real hard about this week, and I think making some extra things that you can do with your castles is part of this. I have two problems right now with the game. One, do you definitely know what's happening, and can you see from this screen what these things have? I'll give you an example. So here's a city. This city looks like any other city. If I click on this city, I see, oh my god, it's got all this cool shit. But I don't know that from this screen. I don't know that this city is different from, say, my city, it also had a bunch of cool shit. I wonder if there's some way we can go in and maybe make this city art more representational of the things that are in it so that I can... Because there were a couple times where I was like, I wonder, you know, this process, that's what this city's got. Okay, boom. Boom. Okay, that's what this city has. I wonder if there's... Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If we could make some better visual changes on the city to show them the upgrades a little bit more, that actually would have a real effect on the gameplay, because you would be able to quickly see, aha! It also would give you a better sense of ownership of the game, because you would feel like, aha, that's my city. Look how cool it is now that I've built it. You know, something as simple as we could remove the walls when you don't have walls, you know. I think that kind of thing makes a real difference. I know it's additional assets, but I kind of want to look and see if we can do that, because I think in terms of what could we add to the game that really adds to the game, I think that makes a real change in the gameplay, that you can see this happening through the game. The other thing is to make it so that defensive gameplay is a bit more of an option. Right now, turtling and playing super defensive is not a great option in this game. It's kind of a recipe for disaster. Because somebody's going to come smack you around sooner or later. And I think we do that by improving some of the defensive bonuses. I'm also looking at one thing that might be interesting is to have some special abilities for the troops that become important when you are actively defending. I'm especially looking at the Revenant and wondering, because that's a weaker race, and I've been thinking about the thought of having the B-class units have a special ability where if you're actively defending, then those units become substantially stronger. that way there's like, oh, okay, you like to turtle? Play the Revenant. The Revenant have got these cool units that really help you turtle. I've been playing around with that idea, and I think we've got... Where are we now? It's May 16th. We're launching this game in about two and a half weeks. I think we've got a little bit more time for me to play with some of these balance issues and see if we can make... I guess what I really want to get to is a place where the levels are not solvable, the races are not solvable, where I can get Kulgan coming in and saying, no, 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 you play it like this, and I've got Merlini X saying, no, 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 you play it like this, instead of everyone sort of coming to a consensus and saying, like, all right, we've played the Fae and we've figured out how they play. Because in that situation, people are going to get tired of the game. And they're gonna say, yeah, okay, I've played this 20 times, and I feel like I've solved it. That's my worry. I don't want people to solve the game. I also agree, the Hero Awakening has been an issue. I certainly noticed it last week when, you know, it was just like, goddamn, they kept awakening heroes over and over and over again. And I felt like, you know, I felt like I was a salmon swimming against the tide where I couldn't even get to their castle because they kept summoning heroes as I struggled to get to their castle. Yeah, I think there's, like I say, I think there's some more balance issues that we can play with. And it's one of the reasons why this week I think we're going to play a lot of multiplayer, because I'm enjoying playing multiplayer and getting people's feedback and having that be a live experience. I want to do that, I want to do that live so that we can actually test some of these changes. And I'm hoping, actually, I'll sit down with the designers today after this live stream, and we'll probably, because some of these changes are literally as easy as going into an Excel file and, you know, changing a number. This is not stuff that takes us a long time to implement, so I see no reason not to fuck around with this a little bit while we still got it in early access and we're still allowed to. Once we actually release the game, we're going to reset all of the high scores, and alright, people are going to get a little more edgy if we go make huge changes to the units. So I kind of want to do some of this stuff over the next week or two. Alright, let's see how the game is going. Merlini X is still in the lead, but very closely followed by Monica, and considering Monica's got Edwin on her side, I think really the Monica-Edwin team may have a chance to smack Merlini around, which just from a purely personal level, I'd like to see happen. But I'm bitter like that, because I was just beaten by him. But
Edwin's down to his last castle.
Ooh, Edwin has lost his last castle. No, he didn't. He took over this castle over here. He's got a castle all the way back in the back lines. But he is losing his original castle. And yeah, actually, Scribble Dude, that's not a bad idea. Why don't we plan for another multiplayer tonight? We'll stream it. I got no problem streaming these multiplayer games. It's fun. So yeah, why don't we plan for like 9 o'clock my time? That's what, 8 o'clock Singapore time. He is a bit of a backstabber, but he's actually very good at the game. So I'm happy to have. Actually, both he and Alara are pretty good at the game, and I'm personally of the opinion that actually Alara's the only one that's good, and like if you were to have a camera in their house, it would be like Alara being like, no, move here, no, move there, no, put that. But that's my secret belief. But yeah, I think it's great having people who are good at the game in the game, because people who suck at the game are not going to break your... They're not going to break your gameplay, right? They're not going to figure out how to min-max your game. They're not going to figure out how to do stuff. You need to have people who are good at your game and who look at the stats and actually use the abilities you give them. Because you put someone in the game who's just kind of fucking around and you try to balance it based off of that, and it becomes very difficult because he's not min-maxing, he's not using... And you want the game to be like that. You want the game to be a game where the guy who invests the time to learn how the units work and the guy who invests the time to learn how to min-max, that guy should win, right? That's the benefit of doing that work. That's why a strategy game is good. If some guy can walk in off the street and not pay attention to all of this stuff and beat the guy who is paying attention to all this stuff, the guy who's paying attention to all this stuff is going to be like, well, fuck this game. This is bullshit. You know, this is just all luck. I'm not playing this bullshit. So, yeah, it's very important in a strategy game to get good players in your testing. So I'm actually really excited. It was... I don't know how many of you guys were here at the end. God, it was fucking 4 in the morning, 5 in the morning, my time here. The sun was rising. I could barely keep my eyes open. And I had people who had not made this game, people who were game players, telling me, no, Chris, move there. No, Chris, do this thing. And I'll be honest, as tired as I was, it wasn't all me being tired. These people were genuinely better at this game than me. And that's fine. I got all kinds of ego. I don't need to be better at my own game than other people. And in fact, I'm rather flattered that somebody would spend enough time in a game that I built to get better at it than me. But there was this period at the end where it was these people who had not made this game holding my hand and helping me through the last level so that I could go to bed. And it was really kind of a special little moment. I was like, wow, this is really cool. These people are coming together as a community. And I felt, you know, I don't know, I keep talking about it, but it was cool. Hey, LA Peacock! So I am dead and spectating. I died very early because MerliniX has absolutely no shame in killing the streamer. There should be a rule. There should be a no-kill the streamer rule. But then that wouldn't be much fun, would it? So we've got Monica at 922 points. Hey, Nelson, can we take a note? When you are spectating, you should get the same pop-ups that tell you that the game will be over in X number of turns. Because right now, Monica's got 922 points. It's 850 victory points to win. I did not get a message that said Monica is about to win because I'm spectating. And I would like to get those messages because it would make it feel more exciting when I'm spectating. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Actually, there's two messages. So you only want to see the message for the winning player.
What's
the losing player? Yeah, the other players would also receive a similar message, a similar pop-up, but with a different message.
Ah, well, we need to see the one. We need to see. Maybe there's a third pop-up that says Monica will win the game in 5 turns.
Okay.
But, like, it should feel a little bit more exciting and hosted because there's not that, the one silent one. Yeah, it should feel a little bit more like, oh, okay, that thing is happening, and you should pay attention to that thing because it's interesting. But right now, we don't have that thing. And so what's going to happen is in a couple turns, this is just going to end. And I'm going to be like, well, why the fuck did it end? Because I didn't get the messages that built up the end for me and made the end exciting and fun. And I should have that build up. All right, Monica, win your game. This is a multiplayer match, but I'm dead. Merlini killed me relatively early in the game, and I'm spectating to see how it ends. It should be over very, very quickly. I'm going to go get another thing of water while this ends, and then if anybody wants to get in on a second round, we'll play one more multiplayer game. Alright, has Monica won yet? Monica has won! Well done, Monica. Alright, who's up for one more multiplayer game? Alright, I will host. Hey, that fail girl is in. We should get her in. That's weird that she's in. My Twitch says she's playing Minecraft. Wait a minute. Is she really playing Minecraft? No. Alright, I'll host a game. Hey, Monica, do we have another six-player level that I don't have unlocked? We must have, right? Monica, you host. Host Tolaroth.
There's at least four six-player maps because I have four unlocked, but I don't know how many there actually are.
Six-player maps.
Yeah, I know Tolaroth is six player. I know Lornwire is six player. Let's play Lornwire. Can you host Lornwire?
Okay.
That's a good map. I'm playing 100 Kingdoms again. I'm sick of playing Faeborn. I like my twins. They're overpowered. The immediately reappearing trends. Oh, look at a full game today. Really, Ben? You're gonna fight me for yellow, Ben? Really? Alright, I'm good. Riftlands, that's the one I couldn't remember. Monica! Click the button! Click the button! We need a button that says, dude, click the button. Like, I can click it, and, like, you get a message, which is like, dude, push your button. Alright, there we go. Did I get my spot? I got my spot! I don't know if it's the best spot, but I just like playing Stone Coast on this game. That's a nice spot. I like that spot right up front. Alright. Alright, I'm good. The alliances have begun.
Who allied with you first?
Well, here's the problem. I'm between Alara and Monica. Monica has already allied with Ben because, of course, she did, right? I'll be damned if I'm going to ever ally with Alara or Merlini ever again, right? That's just a shit life choice right there. And that leaves me with La Peacock for my other options. LA Peacock? It's LA Peacock. We decided it's LA Peacock, didn't we? But LA Peacock is kind of over there. But you know what? I'm gonna offer the alliance anyway. We'll see if LA Peacock goes for the alliance. I'm just saying, if you're not allying with me, that leaves you with Merlini or Alera, and they don't have a great history of allying with anybody else. That's all I'm saying. You're taking your life in your own hands, allying with either of those people. Just a very poor life choice.
They accept your alliance.
LA Peacock did accept the alliance. Which may not be all bad. I mean, what's gonna end up happening now with this particular setup of alliances? Ben's gonna turtle like Ben always does. It's gonna be a fight between me and Monica. Alara's gonna come and poke at my underside while I'm fighting with Monica. And Merlini and LA Peacock are gonna fight. That's how this is gonna play out. And I'm going to get eliminated very quickly again because I'm going to have these two people both poking at me. That's how I believe it will play out. We will see if I am right or not. But that is my prediction. But that card, Lornwire Alliance, is a strong alliance in this game. Yeah, I hadn't really thought about poke at your underside sounding dirty, but yeah, it is kind of dirty in the end. Of course she was there when Merlin stabbed you in the back. That's what they do. See, here's how I predict this is going to go. We're going to open up this game. We're going to release the game. Everyone's going to come in and play. They're going to rise up to the top of their charts. And they're just going to have this, like, this strategy, this constant strategy of finding people who don't know any better, allying with them, and then destroying them. That's how it's going to happen. Wait, where did you not show up? I said you. Come to me. No, not you. You. Is that gonna happen? Yeah, that's gonna happen. It's true, Alara. You will never make friends at this game because of him. He is gonna destroy every young budding friendship that you're gonna put together. The only way you're ever gonna make friends at this game is you gotta play without him some days. You gotta find a game with him not in it. That's the only way you're ever gonna make any friends. Foolish. I love that little bit in the music where the violins cut in. That's always kind of cool. I wonder when Shaz is going to get the new music in. It's been like 2 weeks that he's been working on the new music, and I'm really like eager to hear the new tunes. I'm ready for them, but I haven't heard them yet. Cause we're doing like we're doing tunes by race. So like if you're playing the Fae, you're gonna get the Fae tune. If you play the human, you get the human tune. Which I'm still torn as to whether or not that was a great idea or not. It might be that we did it wrong because you're gonna be playing the humans for a really long time, and then you're gonna be playing the Fae for a really long time. You're playing the same music while you play the whole campaign. So it may have been a mistake. I'm not totally sure if that was a good idea, but we thought that was a good way to break it out. We'll see. But I am actually very proud of this music, and it's all composed from scratch by an in-house artist of Boomzap. That's Boomzap Music. He's an extremely talented artist, sound designer, musician in Malaysia, actually. A guy named Shaz. And he's been making games a long time. He used to work for one of the oldest studios in Southeast Asia. What was the name of that old studio? The one that Brett ran. Game Brains. He used to work for Game Brains, and now he works with us, and has been working with us for... Oh, goodness. I don't know how... Shaz has been with us, I think, 7 years or more. He's been with us forever. And he's always done great music. So, yeah, I'm really pleased with that. The art is also good. Yeah, feel free to go talk about how much you love the game on Steam. Don't let us stop you from that. Yeah, one of the artists is actually in this game right now, Ben. Bad Luck Ben was the animator responsible for a lot of the effects in the game. Pretty much the entire battle scene is him. That's pretty much all him. We do need to put together a world map. That's on my list of things to do. There is the as I was saying in the stream, these levels do all fit together into one big world map. I just need to figure out some way to show that to the player in a way that's interesting. So I don't know if I mentioned it during this. I must have mentioned during the stream. This is the most penis-looking piece of land in the game. I really, like, we were going to change this. It's just so phallic that I felt like that, it's terrible. But I just haven't really gotten around to doing it. Thank God that it's this way. If this map were upside down, it would even have, like, the little ball sack, and it would be terrible. Even as it is, it's awful, but... you know, the mic is working great, except... Every now and then it cuts out, and I have to plug it back in, and I think I need to get a new plug for it, I think is the problem. Alright, wait, I'm getting distracted with other things and need to do things with my things. You need to build one of those, and you need to build one of those. Yeah, alright. Oh, and, hi, Valita Panda! I did, it seems to help. Here, wait. I have my special Hey Valina Panda thing. Wait, no, that's not it. So many pandas. There it is. Hello. All right. I have so many pandas on my thing now. All right. Yeah. Earlier, I was over in Valina Panda's stream, and she was giving me helpful tips about setting up my microphone better and whatnot, because she's smart like that. Seriously, I gotta figure out how to make my hand not keep going numb. I can't feel these two fingers anymore. It's been days. You would think it would be better now. Build. Alright, so how is... Alright, looks like LA Peacock's doing alright. Taking over some land. Not really anything big going on down there. Yeah, alright, everything's going good. So one of these days, I'm going to figure out all of the emoticons in Twitch. I've not... There's got to be just like a slash command for all of them. I just haven't bothered to learn them yet. I need to sit down and learn the slash commands for all the cool emotes in Twitch. Because I like the little girl that says hi. There's a plugin that shows all of them. There's got to be just like a backslash commands command that like shows all of them or something. Or a web... That's the one nice thing about Twitch is because everybody is so... absolutely connected and knows things. It's just a matter of time. If you want to know the answer to any question, it's literally just a matter of typing it in Google and going and watching the video that somebody's made. There's a video for every single thing in the world on Twitch. It's just you have to have the time to go do it, and I have not had such time. But that's all it is. All right, so Monica, what is the command for the friendly little girl that's waving at me? I like her. I like the hello girl.
Hey guy.
What?
LG.
So is it what? Hey. Back? Is it backslash hey guy makes it happen?
No, backslash. Just the words. Hey guys.
That didn't work. I tried it and it did not work.
No, capital H, capital G.
Ah. Oh my god! I've learned something new. I feel like a part of the club now. I can play with the cool kids.
Damn.
There is a little bit of... Okay, so I'll let you know. And nobody's done anything wrong. I don't want to like say that anybody's done anything wrong. But like when I was a young kid... And I think probably because this is we're all gamers and stuff, most people can sympathize with me. I was an enormous nerd. I mean, like a phenomenal, off the charts nerd. A big thick glasses. I played Dungeons and Dragons since I was in third grade, and this is back when you weren't allowed to play Dungeons and Dragons. This is back when only real nerds played Dungeons and Dragons, like old D&D boxed set Dungeons and Dragons. I've tried to read Lord of the Rings when I was in second grade, and I learned how to write all the Elvish runes, and I used to write little notes to myself in class in Elvish. I mean, I was a fucking... a serious nerd, right? I still am. Still am, Ben. But I was an amazing nerd when I was a kid. And I always had that feeling that there was a group of cool kids, and I was not one of them. I mean, it was just... The school was separated amongst the cool kids and the not cool kids, and I was not allowed to be with the cool kids, right? And the cool kids had like shit that they knew that like was part of the whole being cool thing that I wasn't allowed to know. Like, you had to wear this thing or say this thing or whatever, and I didn't understand any of it. I didn't know how to be cool. I just knew how to be a big fucking nerd, right? And sometimes I still like when I go into a new environment, and for me Twitch is a totally new environment. I know I should press the end turn button. I was actually thinking, I was trying to figure out what I could do, but I didn't have any money. So I come into this Twitch environment. And obviously there's people that have been here longer than me, and they know things. They know, they have a history and a background, and they know, oh, this guy is this thing, or this command is this thing, or it's really rude to do this thing in a channel, or it's really cool to do this thing, or there's a basis of knowledge that you get in any community, and when you're new to a community, you don't have that basis of knowledge. And I will give the Twitch community credit for being a very... You know, as online communities go, they have been as friendly and open and nice as a community could possibly hope to be, right? I can't bitch too much, right? Because they have been very warm and friendly and welcoming, and it's been good. But there's still that little bit of feeling of, I don't know what I'm allowed to do or what I'm allowed to say. I don't know what's cool or what's not cool. And I remember, I like have this recollection of being of, it's like I'm all the way back to being fucking 10 years old in second grade again, and not knowing that I wasn't supposed to be wearing the bandana on my left leg instead of the right leg. Yes, we used to tie bandanas around our legs. Like not knowing what was cool. And it's so funny, because I'm a man now, right? I'm like fucking 43 years old. I have children. I run a company. You would think at this point I would have gotten over this shit, right? You would think at some point in your life you would like have, I don't know, matured to where none of this shit matters. And you want to pretend that you're that guy. You're this guy that's too cool for all that bullshit anymore. But the reality is, you're not. Like, that little fucking 10-year-old kid is still there. Like, still scared he's gonna do the wrong thing or, you know, fuck up. Or, like that little scared boy never totally goes away. Right? And I still feel it. It's sad, but it's true. So there's that. There's my sad little story of not fitting in. All right, I'll get rid of that. And you are gonna build me some shit. Come on, dude, build me some shit. But that's it. That's exactly it, Alara. This is when I went to PAX in San Antonio. It was really an amazing experience for me because I could see these people, right? And you saw, and I'm going to be a little bit rude here, but I'm just speaking truth, right? You would see just these fucking nerds, and they were just like, they were out there nerds, you know? They're like, you know, look at my fucking nerd suit that I put on. Absolute, I mean, like, wow, nerds. And you knew, you even now, and you guys don't know, right? You young kids don't know. Being a nerd now, you have, like, being a nerd now is not what it used to be. Like, video games are now part of the mainstream culture. You're allowed to be a nerd today in ways that you were never allowed to be a nerd when I was a kid. The world is much more accepting of nerds. But even in this new world of being highly accepting of nerds, there were nerds at PAX that you were like, dude, you need to dial that shit down, nerd. And I'm an accepting guy, right? I'm not a judgmental. Okay, I'm kind of judgmental, but. But even me, coming from my nerd culture, even with that total story, that story that I just told you, even me, I was like, wow, you can't be serious that you came out in public like that. But they did. And you could tell that that was the one sort of space that they could go to and they could be that person and not worry that anyone was going to give them any shit about it at all. They were totally okay with life being that person. And I thought to myself, this is really beautiful, right? This is, I mean, and yeah, some of them were like really fucking, you know, the scary nerds that you're talking about, right? But they were in a welcoming, compassionate environment that was willing to accept who they were. And that was nice. You know, that was, for me, I really felt, I felt safe. I felt warm and happy, and I felt like, you know, let your fucking freak flag fly there, nerd ass. You're like, I was just, go, you know, I was really supportive of the whole thing. And so, for me, that was PAX, and I came out of it with this just real love for the experience and for that environment, and I have found that largely, not entirely, but largely, Twitch is the similar space. But you know, even now, I mean, like, I was over on Velina Panda's stream earlier today, just hanging out and kind of waking up and seeing what was what. and some dude showed up and just wrote some really fucking sexist bullshit. And immediately, you know, the mod deleted it and it went away and everyone went on about their business and nobody commented on it. But for, you know, for like a period of like 10 seconds, I was like, oh yeah, there's that internet that I know. The internet that finds a woman, fucking sees her on the internet, and immediately wants to talk about his dick. Like, there's that guy. And that fucking asshole is still there, but somehow this community just kind of exists without letting him own it in the way that asshole owns a lot of the rest of the internet. And I don't know exactly how they did it, technically or culturally or whatever, but, you know, it's nice to see. Well, the thing is, they do own the internet in the sense that we all have to deal with them, right? Like we have to change what we do and adjust things. And it's not just the asshole who wants to say sexist shit to the female streamer. That's the obvious target, right? And I mention it because I saw that, an hour and a half ago? But it's also the asshole who wants to troll the board and talk about some bullshit that nobody cares about and nobody wants to hear him, you know? It's also the guy who looks at a game that you can tell somebody spent a lot of time and put a lot of love and a lot of energy into, and all he wants to say is, you know, fuck this, this game sucks, I like Halo. And you're just like, fucking asshole, whatever, man. The assholes own the internet in the sense that we are forced to adjust ourselves to protect ourselves from them. And that always makes me sad. But largely, this environment on Twitch seems to have pretty well told them to go fuck themselves, and I think it's millennials. I think millennials they've been on the internet their whole goddamn lives. They know how the internet works, they know how shit works, and they're just less tolerant of this shit than Generation X was. I think Generation X still takes this shit too personally because we grew up in an environment where this stuff didn't exist, you know? But yeah, I think you're right. They only really own it if you let them own it. But I do think, you know, I was in the middle of saying something, and I got distracted. I've begun to be a bit more optimistic that the world can survive the internet. That we can all come together and learn how to use this technology without just being dicks all the time about it. I've become more optimistic about that than I used to be. And a lot of it has been, has honestly been, it's been a real awakening for me. So, I mean, there was this very hard moment in PAX San Antonio where I don't know, it was a real awakening for me. It was a real, for me, and it's hard to explain because I guess you guys don't have the same experience that I have. I've been in the business of games for a very, very long time. And it's very much a business. We do business meetings and go to business things. There's a convention happening right now, actually, as we speak, down in Singapore that I was supposed to be at, but I actually canceled because I've got way too much things going on in my life right now. And you go to these business conventions and business people talk about business things because this is a business. There's billions and billions of dollars that are spent on it. And that's not an exaggeration. Actual, real-life billions of dollars spent on the game industry. And there are people who make fortunes in this. There are companies that make fortunes in this. And you can get, when you're a developer, you can get caught up in this. And you can forget the actual audience. You can forget the love of what you're doing and the love of games that brought you to this in the first place. You know, I didn't get into games for money. I got into games because I loved games. And it's been nice for me to personally have used this game to refind my love of the gaming environment and of the gaming world and of gamers. It's been a spirit journey for me back to a healthier place, because I got real fucking burnt out. I was, right around Christmas, I was as burnt out on games as a human being could possibly get. I'd had a bunch of free-to-play games fail. I've had all these publishers tell me the only thing that you can possibly make anymore is free-to-play, and it's gotta be these fucking virtual slot machines, and I got to a really dark place with games, where I was starting to think, like, you know what? I'm out. I'm done. If this is what games is, I don't want any part of it anymore. And I've really come around to, what if I can make this work? You know, what if I can somehow make a game like Legends of Callasia, which is not free to play, which is genuinely, I think, giving people value for their money, which is genuinely fun, which is genuinely made by gamers for gamers. Like, maybe this thing can still live. Maybe this beautiful world that I got into games to begin with from, maybe we can still have this dream. And I sound very trippy dippy and you know, granola eaten and whatnot, but it's, I think from the audience side, it's hard to understand this journey. And developers that I talk to are all at some stage in this journey, whether they're still in the process of selling out, or whether they're in the process of recovering from having sold out, or whether they're in the process of rationalizing why they sold out, or whether they're somebody who came into games and never was really about the games to begin with and never really could sell out because they started sold out, you know. And those people exist. They're people that they came into this already sold out. That happens. What to do? You're gonna go down there. You're gonna build me some shit. I can't. I don't have enough money to build. Oh. Man, I seem so poor in this game. I seem like I'm not. I never got no cash. That's all right. What to do? I'm kind of at a loss. Like, green and yellow seem to be going after orange, and I'm gonna leave them to it. Like, I don't want to poke at them. But I don't know how to get over to purple to do any real damage to them and help my ally. I got nothing else to build here. I think it's time to motivate out. I think it's time to head out. Is what it is. You're still kind of in this, LA? Well, not really. That may be the end of you there. That may be it. Hey, Dwarf Furious! The filthy dwarf lover showed up. And he is a beloved and treasured member of the community. That is true. Or at least a member of the community. We can at least call him a member of the community, right? The beloved thing, well, we could, let's call him a member of the community. Let's leave it at that and not get carried away.
Typing. There's some private messages going on.
Well, the problem is I can't private message using our game's private message system because it's on Twitch. I have to use other forces. Let's see here. My take on the Dwarf and Orc DLC is exactly the same as it was before. We will do them if somebody actually buys the game. As much as I want to be all, you know, we do this for love of games, at some point I gotta pay these guys, you know. Monica and Ben and the artists and everybody who worked on this game, they don't do this. I mean, they got families and shit, so we gotta pay them, and I need this game to start selling some units before I can invest a lot more money into it. So, what the current plan is to launch this game, sort of end of this month, beginning of next month-ish. We're still working on an exact date. When we have that done, we will hang on a minute, let me take my turn real quick. I have to do things. You. Yeah, all right. So we'll yeah, we're actually working on giftable copies. That will be what we're actually going to do is we're going to make a normal full purchase version of the game as well, so you can buy that if you want. That's one of the things that we've got planned that we'll do. We'll keep the free-to-play-ish version because I still think it's nice to be able to allow... I need an option for people who buy it over on iOS to be able to come over and get it for free on the Steam store. But we'll also allow you to purchase it directly on Steam as a full premium purchase because it looks like so many people want that. So we're actually going to allow both of those different varieties of purchasing. So yeah, there's that. Hang on, let me take my turn real quick. Because the multiplayer crowd is upset that I'm not moving fast enough. I should go faster and do more things. Alright, you kids. Oh, damn it. I don't have a portal here? I should have built one of those, shouldn't I? Foolish me. Okay. Yeah, so we'll do that, and we'll release that. We'll do a big release. I'm trying to line up some more promotional events for the release to get people really into the release. Very quickly after the PC Mac release, we will do the iOS and the Android release. And when all of that is done, we'll assess where we are and how many copies we've sold and whether or not it looks like this is a viable business. And if it is, then I will do both the Dwarf and the Orc DLCs pretty much immediately. So that's the plan. But a big part of that plan is getting this game out and getting people to buy it and making some money. So if anybody can help us with that, that's huge. And I mean, not to sound like I'm begging for help or anything, but yeah, we will be. We're looking into Gamersgate and whatnot. But I'll be honest with you, Gamersgate is not such the best store in the world, but we'll be on other stores as well. It's all part of the rollout plan. The thing is, you have to be really careful about where you release first, because one of the biggest and most important parts of releasing is having somebody feature you. And to be quite blunt, unless you kind of give somebody that little bit of extra love, they won't feature you. And the biggest extra love you can give is give them a week or two of release where you're not releasing on a competing system. So right now we are very, very interested in making sure that Steam promotes us and giving Steam a couple weeks of sort of premium access to the game is a relatively good way to do that. But yeah, I mean, you know, to be honest with you, stuff like everybody showing up for the streaming event last week and people who are streaming the game right now, I can't say thank you enough. This is how you get people excited about a game right now. And I know that we don't have, you know, people who play this game care about this game. And we move up and we build from there. So yeah, anyone who wants to, even, and it doesn't matter if there's only four people watching your stream. Just the little bit by little bit, and this is what grassroots organization looks like. You know, it looks exactly like this. It looks like little bit by little bit us getting better. And you know, we don't have the biggest audience in the world right now, but we do have a really active audience. You know, people who play this game care about this game, and we move up and we build from there. So, yeah, anyone who wants to, even, and it doesn't matter if there's only four people watching your stream, just the fact that you click on Legends of Callasia and there's four people streaming it right now, that makes a difference. And, you know, we get some other people who have larger audiences streaming it as well. My guess is those people who've been streaming it for a while and have some sort of history on it, it'll be a really great way to bring those people into your streams as well. I'm hoping that this goes both ways. And that in the long term, being somebody who was involved with us from the very beginning will help you on your stream in the same way that your stream is helping us sell the game. I'm hoping it works that way, but we'll see. Like I say, this is all new to me. I don't know how the Twitch works. But the thing is, the whole fucking Twitch environment's only what, a year old? Nobody knows how it works. You know, it's we're on brand new ground for everybody now. Shit, you still haven't taken that? I should not have played that fortification. That was a bad move in my part. But you know what? I know I want that. I know I want that. But you know what I want more? I want to walk now. I'm gonna finish taking that. Hey, wife. Yeah, finish the turn. Yeah, I'm cool with that. Oh, hey, I got a card from my parents. Let's see what they had to say. It's a thank you card. Ah! For the Mother's Day flowers that you sent. Note, I said she sent. I would not be a good son if it were not for my wife. She makes a better son of me. Alright, let's see. Things are changing. Let's see here, you're gonna defend, and you're going to go over there, is what we're gonna do. You've got Greg with you, right? Yeah, you got Greg. Okay. I just couldn't tolerate seeing Monica win the game. And I'm willing to lose to not let Monica win the game. I'm willing to let that happen. I had an ally, and my ally is gone, and now I'm just gonna fight with whatever I got left. Holy shit, 16 catapults? That's not good. Ow, 16 catapults stings. Alright,
alright. That's the way you want to play?
Is that you talking trash? Are you talking trash at me? Alright, let's see here. Let's see, some of those, a couple more of those, a couple of you guys to do some dying. Alright, let's go. Let's see. Not that. This. No? Alright. I just had to throw a wrench in the gears. See, now I've pissed off Ben. I'm gonna die for my sins. You know this, right? There's no way I'm gonna I thought maybe I could keep Monica from winning, but I don't see it happening. I think Monica's got this game. I pulled her down a little bit, but I think that's as far as it goes. I think we gotta retreat. We gotta back up. Let's see. I'm hurting. All right. Let's see. Anaconda Ben has found his prey. See, I'm pretty sure that I'm about to get my ass handed to me. But the question is, can Alara, with her one hero and one tiny citadel, and Merlini X with his, what, two cities, can they take advantage of my extremely incompetent and rather ineffective backstabbing? Is that possible? What will be the ramifications? Alright. Indeed, it was a power shot. Wait, I have a power shot? Yes. Power nut shot! I can't believe we made it. I think Alara's still out of the game. I don't see any hope for her at this point. But at least I've forced Monica to take a few more turns to win the game. I think that's all I've really achieved, is I've delayed her inevitable victory. The inevitable cold claw of failure. I feel it sitting on my neck even as we speak. You know, part of me feels like it's a little bit lame that the game is so much about the alliances, but then part of me thinks that's what's fun about it. Like, that's its thing. Is it really does, this alliance system really does create, like, a, you're going to win or lose the game based on how well you can talk somebody into being in an alliance with you. There is some interesting fun to that. Oh man, did I waste that card? I did waste that card. No, I didn't. One of you is going to stick around? I'm going to trash you. I like the disbodied hands reaching in the shelves behind me on the camera. It's kind of cool. Hmm. this was probably a mistake, but let's see how it plays out. Joy! The piece by piece destruction of Monica begins! Joy! I shouldn't enjoy this so much. Backstabbing my own staff. It's really not cool. I really am kind of a dick when it comes to this game. I had not realized that when I read that message that the whole world could see that message. And this is why Merlini and Alara always win, because deep down, they are always allied, right? That's the thing. We're like, at the same time, I'm offering an alliance, he offers it to me. Yes, yes, the old Boom Zap forces ride forth. We're like the tribes of Scotland, you know. If we could just get over destroying ourselves all the time, we would win games. We're our own worst enemies. Should have attacked Chris's castle at the very beginning. There's only so many alliances in a game. Oh, I would feel guilty about what we've done to Monica if I wasn't enjoying it so much. That's the joy of backstabbing, is to backstab the person who you relied on to get to where you are right now. That's what really makes it backstabbing. Oh, I'd feel guilty if I wasn't having so much fun. And you see, this is good theater. This is... You show me this in fucking Call of Duty streams. No, this is better theater than Call of Duty. joy. If Merlin wins this game, though, I'm officially upset. if we've just handed this game to Merlin, I'm gonna be very upset with us, Ben. Alright, so Alara is actually not out of the game yet, which is surprising. I had thought she was out before this. Alright, this is how this has gotta go down. What do you got going on there? Yeah, all right. I like how Monica is still scrappily staying in this. I'm impressed with that. I got smitified, and peasant revolted too. Let's see here. We'll want some of those. And we'll want you to head down there. Yeah, alright. This game is beautiful. I love everything about it. Alright, so he's got 40 troops on my 11. What? got misdirected? Ah! Doesn't matter, you're not getting off that country. You're staying there. You're to the death. Dragons, catapults, a whole bunch more of those. A bunch of those. What? What, Ben? What is this? What is this foolishness? No! No, Ben! What's wrong with you? Ah! We had it! We had this game! Ah! Ben, you fool! Ah! This is why we can't have nice things, Ben. Oh. Oh, the rage. The rage. Ben and I had this game. The team of Chris and Ben had this game, Monica. We were gonna win without you. And now he's brought your sad, desiccated corpse back into this alliance. Oh. Oh, the pain. Oh. Oh. Oh, oh, this hurts. I'm not gonna forget this, Ben. I am not gonna forget this. This moment will live for a very long time. Oh, that stung. Wait, can I? Yes, yes, yes. Oh, Ben, Ben, Ben. Oh, Ben, Ben, Ben. Foolish boy. I'm not sure what good that'll do, but I'm in. I'm in. I'll play. I'll take what I can get. At least this means you won't attack my guy there on that castle. This is like some sort of like Scottish romance history of like, you know, the warring tribes or something. Ah, the McDougals! They've burned me for the last time. Oh, two heroes dead. That's gonna sting. But I did manage to take this city. That's worth something. That's progress of a sort. Alright. Time to reconsider. Yeah, alright.
I'm out!
So Monica's out.
Yeah, that was my gift in this game, was just to kill someone.
I like how you've lowered your expectations. That's really the path to real spiritual victory. Lowered expectations. Alright. I guess we come down here and, do this thing. All right, off you go. Let's go kill Ben. Time to go kill Ben. All right, the real question of the day, though, is how much can I trust this Alara? Like, I know better than I've been allied with her before. This is not my first time to that particular dance.
The other thing to consider is she has one hero with like five guys. What could she possibly do to you?
Well, yes, but there's how she could help me, which is you've got that pile of heroes right there that makes it difficult for me to go do what I need to go do to Ben. And she could come up around and at least poke at you and keep you, but she's not gonna.
I have a feeling Merlin and Alara have a secret plan.
Oh, I'm 100% certain they have a secret plan. There is no doubt in my mind that there is a secret plan involved. But who
there
else am
no
I?
There is no plan in the world that could salvage this game for either one of us.
All right, let's see.
Alara can occupy Merlin's castle because they're no longer allies, and after that they can go back to allying again, leaving Chris all alone.
All right, let's see. You're gonna portal over to there. Yeah, all right. See, I think Ben's gonna lose, is what I think. I'm beginning to get highly optimistic that I'm gonna tear Ben a new asshole. That's what I'm beginning to think.
I'm pretty sure that's correct. He lost a lot of guys fighting over there, so.
Yeah, because he's got two heroes there that are kind of stuck in that. I'm about to go. He's got nothing back up there that he can really do much to me with. I'm cautiously optimistic. But I'm gonna lose my city down there. I should have defended that. I should have done something about that. All right, but that's all right. It's not too late. I got portals. That's why God made portals. All right, my pile of ballista is going in the right direction. Alright, what's Ben up to? Ben won? Ah! Damn. It's not good for me. Ben winning there is not good for me. Aw, oh, damn, my teleport nuke didn't work properly. My nuke-a-port. Yeah, Ben. Take that, Ben. I'm Team Alara. Jesus, 193? Where'd you get that huge army, Ben? Holy shit, he killed all 26 catapults in one go? Oh, fuck me. That's not good. Oh, that's not good at all. I'll be wanting that army later. Oh, that's not good. Alright, let's see. What to do, what to do. All I have to do is not lose anything to Ben for 3 turns. Alright. You go over there. And you... some dudes. Or wait. Hang on. Alara's still actually allied to me. Alright, cool. That's different. We'll see if that lasts. Now, actually, I'm not going to buy any more dudes right now. I'm going to see what Ben does. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to play it quiet and safe. Don't you dare give this game to Ben. Don't you dare. Don't do it. Don't give this game to Ben. He does not deserve this game. Ben does not deserve this game. Not at all. How did I drop down to 690? What did I lose? Just that one city was worth that much? That blows donkey balls.
It was the continent. You lost the continent.
I lost the what?
You lost the continent, the whole kingdom there.
Ah, that's right, because I lost the continent. Yeah, alright. That makes sense now. Damn it. I can't believe you're gonna give this game to Ben. Ben doesn't deserve this game. Gonna win this? No! I protest! Of course you allied with Merlini, didn't you, Ben? You bastards! Oh, you bastards! I cry foul! Oh, this was a good game, though. All right, Ben wins. I got nothing I can do here. Oh. Alright, that was a good game. That was a phenomenally good game. And that's all the time I have for streaming today. We're going to call it done. I'm going to drop off of all these things. I'm on so many things right now. But the big thing I'm going to drop off of is I'm going to stop streaming. We will be back tonight. I'm going to stream some more multiplayer games tonight at 9 o'clock my time, 8 o'clock. That would be 8 o'clock a.m. East Coast, 8 o'clock p.m. Manila, 9 o'clock p.m. Tokyo, fuck only knows what time that is, West Coast, 4 hours before, like 4 a.m., I don't know what, something like that. Anyway, thank you very much, we'll be back tonight, and back again tomorrow, same time, same channel. Thanks, everybody!